Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creating Process, and today we'll be designing this very unique style of logo design. There are a number of pieces which are split together to form this shape of an elephant. Each piece is placed one above the other, casting a shadow on the below surface. So to design this logo, we'll use the rectangle tool and create out the basic shape. Then with the help of pen tool, we'll create a few of the shapes which are a little complex. Then after that, we'll select everything and fill this up with the gradient color. Then we'll tweak each pieces precisely. So let's begin the tutorial. Before that, we'll create out the base of the logo design. So I'll select a rectangle tool and left click my mouse button here. I keep the width around 240 and height around 160 and click OK and create a rectangle of that dimension. Then I placed it according to this. So I bring out the ruler, Control R, and just place it around here and place this aligning with this. Now after that, this is the overall dimension inside which I'll be creating my logo. So I bring out this, here's the ruler, and first thing what I'll do is I'll just make sure that this line matches here. So I'll bring out, and this is for the stomach area. I'll just bring it out. From here, I'll just give a half inch distance from here, from the back side, and from the front I'll give her 1 inch, so around this much. Now select everything and lock it, Control 2 to lock. Now next thing, we need to create out the body, and before that we need to make sure giving some distance here, so I'll just drag out. And we need to see here, you can see for head distance we need around this much. Let's give it some distance for the head. Now let's create the body. So to create out the body, I'll use the rectangle tool and give some stroke color, and from here, from the top, standing and giving some body size around this much. Then for the back body, I'll just draw out a rectangle and place it around this much. Now I'll draw a leg. I'll draw out one more rectangle for the back leg, and for the front leg one more, extending this much. Now for this tail one, I'll just draw one more rectangle from here and extend it till this much, giving it some depth. Then from here and extend it till this much for the tail. Then for the head portion, I'll just draw one from here and giving it some this much gap between them, you can see here, and we make sure to extend this till this much. And after that, I have to draw one more, giving some this much and this much. Okay, then I zoom again in, I'll just draw one more from here, giving that end piece, this one, like that. And I'll draw out this with the help of pen tool. So I'll just draw out from here using the pen tool, giving some this portion going till this much. Yes, and here for the ear, and finishing it at here. In the same way, I'll draw one more one starting from here, touching it here, and this, then one going around here. Okay, and finishing it around here. We need to make one more rectangle around here, so I'll just draw one more rectangle in the same way, giving it some this much. Okay, let it be. Now next thing we need to do is to tweak out each rectangle. So let's tweak it from the back. I need this, so I'll just tweak it out with the handle direct selection tool and just tweak it out, selecting the with the direct selection, selecting the point, just move it around and maintain the shape. In the same way, selecting this, I'll just delete one point from here, and I got that shape. In the same way, I need to add few points here, you can see I need to add one, so I'll just select this first and add a point here. So just select and add a point, and after that I'll just, with the use of direct selection tool, just tweak it in, and this one just place it along this way, and this one, selecting this with the direct selection tool handle, just place it around here, maintaining that, cover it up. Now you can see this is done. With the lag, I'll just play around with this also. I'll just make sure it's like this, and I can just make sure to push it around this much, a little bit. And in the same way for the top one also, I'll just make sure to bring it around here, giving that nice flow, then around here, and this one bring it around here. Now I'll go for here front leg and do the same stuff. I'll just extend this much, a little bit more, this much, like that, you can see. Okay, now I'll work out with this body, so I need some cut here. So to make sure that, I'll just add a few points here. First one around here, then after with the die selection tool, I'll just place this point to this leg and this one push it up till this much. In the same way, I'll select this one and push it up to this much. So we got that nice cut here. Now let's go to the front part. Let's do this. So I just select this one and with the pen tool, I just delete this one point from here. We got that nice piece here. In the same way, I select this and with the pen tool, I just delete this point from here. And we got that. And I'll just do little stuff. I just push this to this much, giving that nice, you can see, cut here. And this is all. So after doing all of this, just make sure everything is in the correct place. This one place to be here. Okay, I think everything is fine. Now I select everything and with the shape builder tool, I'll just make sure to make this one pieces. So this one is one, this one is ear. So this is one piece, this one is one piece, this and this one is one piece. Once I've done everything, I'll just select everything first and with the eye picker, with the shift and alt press, I'll just select this gradient color. You can see I've got a gradient color here. Here I have applied blue and at the corner it has dark. So I just select that and it's filled up. Okay, I have missed one stuff. I'll just go in there with the die selection tool, select that vertex and just push it up till this much and done. We have done. Now let's work with this. We need to tweak the gradient color. So I'll first of all, what I'll do is I'll unlock everything and remove all the guidelines, locking the background, select all the guidelines, delete this one also, delete. Now I'm left with this elephant. Now let's work with the color. So first I select everything and with the gradient tool selected, you can see all the green colors are here and all the handles are here. So let's work with that. First thing, we need some here. So I'll just go from the back, selecting this individually, we'll be doing that. So I just rotate this to here and extend it till here and just make sure to bring it around till here. And I'll be giving some constant gradient length. So if I fix this, you have to fix it for all of them. So make sure, so I'll just extend this much and extending this till this much and giving that much depth. In the same way, I select this handle and do the same stuff. We need to do a little bit of extension here till this much. Let's check it out. Okay, I think we don't need to give this here. I'll just place it like that and I'll go here. Let's check it out. Okay, we need to work off with this. Just rotate this, selecting this, I'll just rotate it to this angle and now I'll just place it to around here. You can see that, yes. And I'll just give a little bit of shorten this gradient handle and place it in the proper place like that. Now let's see. Okay, we need to work with the lag. So I just rotate this and make it till this angle and I just push this down a little bit more and we need to give a little more longer. So I just push it down and make it a little bit longer, giving that nice depth. In the same way, selecting this, I'll just do is first rotate it to that angle. Like you can see, I need to give that angle. And after that, I'll just make sure to give that much length to that and place it in the proper place. Okay, I need to do a little bit of rotation here, little bit, you can see, yes, like that. And we need to tweak out with the this. I think we will keep the ear like that. Then this, I need to rotate this to this angle, giving that nice one and just extend it till this much and place it there. Let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. Now this one, I'll just rotate it to this angle in the same way and place it around this much and extend the handle till this much, giving almost every handle to be giving that same length. That will give some nice effect. Now this one, I'll select this and extend this till this much and giving that nice. Okay, and to rotate this a little bit more like this angle, you can see we have got a tilted one, and I'll just extend this little bit here and till this much. So overall, let's check it out. Okay, this is good, this is good, this is good. I have left this piece. Okay, I have left this piece. Okay, that's fine. Now once I have covered up everything, let's do the next step. So I select this, you can see this and this. Okay, and with the eye picker, I select that normal color from here. That means we are not applying gradient color on that. And after that, I'll just select this, arrange it to front. Okay, let's check me. Okay, that's fine. And this one also arrange to front. Now I'll just duplicate this one more. Control C, Control F, and top one, Control 2 to lock it. Now selecting the back side, I'll just select this color eye, dark one. Oh no, this one. This is if you check it out, I filled this up with dark blue color, and after that I reduce the opacity to 30 degrees. So that's the way I'm just place it, and I'm just playing it around with this. Let's check me like that. Okay, I'm placing it properly, and after that I'll just give effect blur, Gaussian blur, preview it. Okay, that's nice. A little bit you can give more, and after that I'll do is I'll just tweak it out. So I need to do the tweaking part here. Just make sure to give that nice tweaking like shadow here. This one I need to extend this till this much, giving that feel, and this point I'll just extend this till this much. Okay, now you can see it out, and like that, placed it. I'll just move it a little bit inside. Okay, and I'll just increase the opacity to maybe 40. Check it out. Okay, that's good. In the same way for this also, I'll do this, and Control C, Control F, Control 2 to lock it, and selecting the back one, I'll just extend it to front, and with the eye picker, I select that color from here. I have already made it, and after that, what I'll do is effect, blur, Gaussian blur, preview it. Okay, that's nice, and let's place it there like that. You can see it out. Okay, that's looking great. I can just push it a little bit more, so giving that more depth, and placing it in the back position like that. Okay, that's not good. I'll just extend this a little bit front, or maybe like this. Okay, that's good. Now you can see we have given that all this depth, and if you look at it, it's looking good. And if you're not, you can just go on and tweak it out more and more, and you can get the best output here. Let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. I think our design is a little bit shorter than before. First of all, unlock everything, Control Alt 2, and lock the background, and I'll select this and just extend this a little bit. Or maybe with the direct selection tool, I select these points, and if you check it out, it's the body which is getting shorter. So I just extend this up, and now it's in the perfect place. Last thing we left with is the font. So I'll just type out SPLIT split, and the font which I'm using here is Nirmala UI. I just select it from here, and it's bold. And the size I'm using is around, I think, 16. And let's give some character distance. So I'm giving some distance between each alphabet, I think around 150. Check it out. Okay, we can just play around. I'll just with a scroll key, I'm just playing it around. Or maybe it's around 3000. Or maybe I can just select this, and with the eye picker, select this, and it's done. So I'll just place it here in the proper place, and we have applied font and text and the color. And the color for the font which I'm using here is this one, dark one. And this is for the gradient color. This one is the plain color. This one is for the shadow. And this one is for the font. If I go in here, you can see this color is gradient. If I go in the gradient color, you can see this is the applied color which I have used. Here's the normal, here's the dark. I have pushed this to the side, creating some instant shadow here like that. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.